As we continue our discussion about college level discussion posts and looking at reputable sources, I want to spend some time talking about evidence-based practice. You may have heard me say that, you may have seen those terms somewhere else, but what does that actually mean? Evidence-based practice is the result of using the scientific method to determine that something actually works or meets the goal or provides the therapeutic event that we're hoping to happen or prevent something from happening. So how do we get to evidence-based practice? Well, it's beyond the scope of this course to go too deeply into this, but know that when we're looking at our science and using the scientific process, we utilize evidence-based practice to guide our knowledge and understanding. So all current medical treatments, practices, and medications have been studied. And there are several different types of research methods that can be utilized and a five-step process to get through research. And once the research has been conducted, it is then published so that peers, scientific peers, can look at this information and make sure that the study was done well, that the study results are valid, and that it can be reproduced. So all of these pieces and parts, and I've simplified it very much, but all of these pieces and parts go into determining what is evidence-based practice. And then protocols and treatments and procedures can be based on the evidence that it was proven to work. So when I talk about a reputable source, I'm always talking about a source that is basing the information on evidence. When we look at most of our social media and even our news broadcasts, this information is not always based on science. It's based on opinion or anecdotal evidence, meaning they think that it makes something happen, but not based on research or evidence-based practice. So as we go through our college discussions, I want you to start stretching those muscles and really looking at reliable information. Where might you find reliable information? Because we don't want to give our opinion. We want to give the research that we've done based on evidence-based practice, based on reliable resources. So when we're looking for reliable resources, most of the time, if you go to a website that is GOV from the government, .edu or .org, most of the time, that information will be based on fact and or research and science. But generally, if you just Google something, there's a good chance that the person that is providing you that information has just purchased that space to be on the top of that Google search. So another place you might think about going when you're looking for reliable information and scientific information is choosing Google Scholar. You go to scholar.google and there's a whole nother Google for research. There's a whole nother section, a whole nother world for you to find some of these research studies that have been published and reliable information. The next thing I want you to do when you are looking for resources is perform the crap test. And you're going to have a little video that is going to walk you through what that means. But in short, it's an acronym that stands for credible, reliable, accurate, and purpose. Whenever you read something online, I want you to think to yourself, what are they trying to convince me of? What is the purpose of this information? Are they trying to convince me or persuade me to believe a certain way? If they are, most likely it's crap, and we don't want to use it as evidence. So as we go through our discussion posts over the next few weeks, I want you to start really just trying to stretch these muscles. And instead of giving an answer based on your opinion or something you've read, I want you to look at reliable resources, and I want you to perform the crap test for those resources and look at evidence-based practice. Okay, talk to you soon.